Hello everybody, my name is Errichto and let's solve a coding interview problem find peak element from LeetCode.com. In this problem we are given a sequence of numbers, nums, where no two adjacent elements are equal, and we are supposed to find a peak element, an element that is strictly greater than both its neighbors, both adjacent elements to the left and right. We should also assume that elements at index minus 1 and n, so the two elements outside the array, are equal to minus infinity. So element 0, index 0, will be greater than its left neighbor, and the same at the end of the array. In case of multiple peaks, we should return any one of them. And the required complexity is logarithmic. Let's see and analyze some examples first. In the first given example, we are given sequence 1, 2, 3, 1, and it's drawn here on the right. And in that case, the only peak is right here. It's an element that is greater than both adjacent elements. A sequence can look more complicated, like the one on the right, where we have multiple peaks and we can return any one of them. And also, a sequence can be just increasing or decreasing. And in that case, a peak would be, in case of an increasing function, a peak would be the last element. Let's remember that we assume that the element after the array with index n instead of n minus 1 has value minus infinity. So it's smaller than any element here. Now let's think how we would implement that in linear complexity, just to iterate over the array, the given array, and check every element as a possible peak. Well, here's the implementation, where we just iterate over index from 0 to n minus 1 in this line, and then check whether an element is greater than the previous element with index I minus 1, or maybe this index is 0, then by default it's greater because the minus 1 value is minus infinity. And similarly, we check whether an element is greater than the next element at index I plus 1, or maybe I is equal to n minus 1. If both these cases for greater than previous and the next element are true, then we return this index. So this code just returns the first valid peak as an answer. And let's remember that we can return any of the peaks. Just here we end immediately when we find one. Now let's analyze this problem and try to think how to solve it in logarithmic complexity. What is the single most famous problem where we are given an array and we are supposed to find something in logarithmic complexity? Well, for sure it's binary search. It's a problem, for example, where we are given a sorted array and we are supposed to find value x, or maybe the smallest value greater than x. Then we just check the middle element of the array, we compare that with x, and we go to one of the halves. Maybe we can do something similar here, even though the sequence might be not sorted. Let's think about it. If we know, let's say, first and last element, and we ask about the middle element, maybe we can deduce to which half we should go with our binary search. In this case, I claim that we can go to this half, to the second half, if first element is smaller than the middle element and the last element is even greater, because for sure there will be a peak here. How to prove it? So why is there no function where there will be no peak in this interval? Well, from the last element, if we go down, so the second last element is smaller, then we have a peak right here. This element is greater than both its adjacent values. And otherwise, if we go up to the second last element, then I claim that we can't go up forever. Eventually, we must go down to the previous element because the middle element is smaller than this last element. So before getting to middle element, we at least once must go down, maybe like that. And here we would have a peak. Maybe that going down would be just to the middle element, but still we would have a peak right here. So this is a proof why we can go to this half. So it looks very reasonable, and maybe we can turn that into a full solution, but it turns out that we just considered a case that is easy to do. And let's think what happens if the middle element is in the middle. Again, we should decide whether to go to the left or right half. And here it is impossible to deduce that only from these three values. Why is that? Well, because there are examples of functions that have a peak only here, and examples of functions where a peak is only in the first half. For example, this sequence would have a peak here on the right, while a different sequence like that would have the only peak on the left, right here. So the issue is, if from these three values we, for example, decide that we go to the second half, then maybe the function, in fact, the sequence given in the input looks like that, and then we wouldn't find a peak because it's here. And it was incorrect in binary search to go to the second half. So we must improve our solution. We know that it isn't enough to just know these three values. And so let's think how to fix the problem here. Okay, we know that knowing the three values, first one, middle one, and the last one isn't enough. So since we care about the order of two neighbors, two adjacent elements, what about asking about the middle element and one of its neighbors? Maybe two. We should consider both cases. So if, for example, the previous element is larger, then it suggests that maybe we should look for the peak only here. Let's think whether it's correct. Well, so we know that this second, this previous value before the middle element is greater than this middle value. We have some first element. And also, at least at the beginning of the process, we know that on the left from the first value in the sequence, there is some minus infinity. And same for an element after the last one. So this is minus infinity and this is minus infinity. So is it correct that there is a peak somewhere here? It turns out that there is. Why? Well, because just like we previously proved for a wrong solution, that wasn't enough because we would have to consider all other cases. Starting from this first element, either we go down immediately, and then this is a peak, because the element left from that is minus infinity, or we go up, and before we reach the middle element, we must at least once go down, because we go down here, from the second last element to the last one. So maybe the function will look like that, maybe a bit different, maybe with multiple peaks, but it's impossible that we go only up from first value to the middle one, because there is at least one step down right there. So there is a peak in the middle. Okay, and now if the value on the left from the middle value is smaller than the middle value, then let's think whether the same is true on the right. So it's enough to consider maybe this interval. So from the middle value to the last value, and the same logic turns out correct. Well, a similar logic, because this time from the left, so from the middle element, if we go down first, then we have a peak here because we know that its left neighbor is smaller here, or we go up. Maybe for some time we go up, and even if this last value is a big one, so even if it's possible that we go only up, then we go down eventually here. So this would be the peak element. What about a full solution and a proof of correctness? We have some interval of indices that we want to consider from L to R. Initially from 0 to n minus 1. We know that just before element at index L, there is a smaller element here, the same after R. and we want to ask about middle element in this interval, let's say it's here, and about its previous element, so some m and m minus 1, and if that previous element is greater, like in this case, then I claim that we just go to this interval from this, from L to this place, and I claim that there is a peak here. Why? Well, we proved that previously, that from L either we go down and we have a peak immediately, or we go up for some time, and the first moment when we go down is a peak, or maybe we go up all the time up to this m minus 1, but then it's a peak itself because it's greater than the previous value and the next value. So we have a peak here, and also the assumption that we took that L is greater than the previous element, the same for R, is also true for this interval from L to M minus 1, because we know that this element, the end of the new shorter interval, is greater than the next element right here. And the same proof will work here. If this element M is greater than M minus 1, then we should go to this interval, and also the assumption about greater than previous element would be true, and we could prove that there is a peak right here. Now it's time for the implementation. Similarly to the standard implementation to binary search, we create some interval where an answer should be from L to R, initially from 0 to n minus 1, like here, and while this interval is not of size 1, so L is smaller than R, we take m, the middle element, as l plus r divided by 2. Since I want to compare it to the previous element, here I must round it up. So in C++ it would be plus 1 and then divide by 2. So this rounds up, l plus r divided by 2. If you aren't sure in binary search whether to put plus 1 here, then just consider an interval of size 2. So what happens if L is equal to, for example, 5 and R equal to 6? If you think what is the value here for this interval, you will see whether you have an infinite loop or maybe you go outside of the array. So just try, always try with interval with L and R then greater by 1, like 5 to 6. And now, as we said in the drawing, we compare element m with m minus 1, and if nums of m minus 1 is greater than nums of m, then we go to the left interval, so now r becomes m minus 1, we change the interval to the first half, and otherwise l becomes m, because we change the interval to the second half. That's the end. When this while loop finishes, L is equal to R, so we know that the solution must be exactly here, so we return either L or R. They are equal, so it doesn't matter. Finally, now let's try to submit that and see whether it works correctly, and it's accepted. So you might find this solution quite complicated because there were some cases the proof of correctness was quite hard, and there is an alternative solution here. So this one is a bit more tricky to come up with, but what we can do is we can see that the differences of two adjacent elements are very important. So if we change this sequence, or at least imagine changing this sequence into a sequence of differences, so let's imagine that we here treat diff of I as nums of I minus nums of I minus 1. Let's just imagine that. Then what we know about this sequence of differences and what are we looking for as a peak element? Well, we know that a peak is such a place where there is a positive difference to the next element and then negative 1. And we also know from this minus infinity thing that diff of 0 is positive, is let's say plus inf, because it's element at index 0 minus element at index minus 1. We also know that element diff of n is minus infinity, because it's minus infinity minus some element from the input. And so this sequence of diffs starts with plus infinity, ends with minus infinity, so starts with positive value, ends with negative value. And you can binary search there. Let's draw that, actually. What do we know about this sequence of diffs? It starts with a positive value, ends with a negative value. And we can just binary search here. So ask about a middle value. And if it's negative like here, then just go to this interval. Because it's also an interval where first value is positive, last value is negative. So if we take the half and so on, we will eventually find a place where there is a positive value and then negative one. And it represents the peak in the initial array. So you might want to implement this alternative solution yourself, but at the end it will turn out very similar to this one, maybe equivalent, because actually if we slightly change this condition, it's equivalent to comparing nums of m minus nums of m minus 1 with 0, and here actually we check whether a difference at some place is smaller than 0. So this is just an alternative solution that has much easier proof of correctness. If you want to try to solve a similar problem, also on non-trivial binary search, I will put a link to some CodeForces problem in the description below. And that's it. I hope you liked the video. If yes, consider subscribing to the channel and liking this video, and see you next time. Bye bye.